What is new? What, which new information can we learn by your instruments, by the code that you know how to operate? Which challenges we can address and which are hopefully are not known to anyone else in the world? So we can find how those systems behave. We can explore their thermodynamic and statistical properties at zero Kelvin when there is a conflict. There is a so-called magnetic frustration when spins do not know which configuration is better. So they are of the equal energy and they compete with each other, and it makes a lot of uncertainty for the ground state. And there are not much experiments that can look inside into the individual properties of the spin, although there is a hunt for such experiments, but there are macroscopical observables that one can easily track. So, and the one of them is heat capacity, and another of them is magnetization. So since we are at the chemistry biochemistry department, the heat capacity will be primary tool, and magnetization will be like if someone has steam to do a little bit more, if you decide the project is too easy and you want to invest time, you can add a little exploration, exploration of magnetization, and then add it to the final report. So the and total energy and heat capacity, they also depend on magnetic field. So even if you forget about magnetization itself, you can look onto the response of the system to change of magnetic field. And depending on whether it is zero or some substantial, it can show different thermodynamical properties. And one of the tricks that we are doing, you have noticed that magnetic field is set to non-zero value. It is done intentionally because it saves system and researchers who study it from this paradox that we want to finally address. So with strong magnetic field, degeneracy is lifted and system becomes a little bit easier. But as magnetic field goes to zero, the problems increase, and we may want to have some reference point that makes our life easier at the beginning. So I'll show a couple of slides later, but free talk is better at the beginning. So I plan for all of us together feel a table. And you may have seen it in the attachment. It will be tic-tac-toe, 3x3 table, and the cells here should be filled by the names of class attendees. So I'll explain so that you have time to think and find the way to select a subject where you can show your strengths in a better capacity and hide your weakness in the best ways. So we are going to practice Roman Empire principle, divide and conquer. So this challenging problem can be chopped on a few little things. And with this, fairly everyone can do the share within an hour, which will be worth of the accomplishment for the whole semester. Of course, we will try to analyze and think deeper, but with splitting responsibilities, it should be easier. And in the very, very oversimplified way, basically one project is one figure. It's better if you add several like figures with slight modification of parameters, but as a minimum, one figure per thing. And then the plan, so that you play open cards. If we follow this holy grail of making a paper with all attendees of the class as authors, which would be really great if it is possible. I mean, it's too early to guarantee. We can do it like relatively short, and figures of the same style for three values. So combined together, this will be figure one for the paper, then three things. I think capacity for different values will be figure two, and this one will be figure three. And then we'll wrap up the text. But so that you feel easier, we will focus on each one, we'll focus on a little thing. The stuff that we have practiced, the version of the code that you did run while making presentations, was for negative value of negative, right? So it was set up to promote ferromagnetism when it gives minimum when all spins are oriented in the same direction, and with all spins in the same direction and non-zero magnetic field, it is single ground state and things are safe. So in some sense, the first column is easier because it's just running with what you already have. The second column for no spin-spin interaction, this who was presenting parameters?
I did.
Thank you. So as taught us, you know, at the beginning of the code where to set this value, so it will be not big change compared to others. And results computed for this value will be very similar to the stuff that we derived on the board here and in your homeworks. So it will be same result as single spin, but multiplied by number of spins. And it is not as challenging and new, but it is a solid reference point. Like those who will focus on this value can double check that the code working and comes into agreement with expectations. And then it will add validation to the future paper if you decide to do one. And the third one is most challenging. There are chances that the code will fail, and then we will, may need to find some backup solutions. Maybe one can explore at extremely high magnetic field, and then it will work. And as one goes to lower and lower value to the field, it brings some numerical instability and fails. So it's an unexplored area, and it would be interesting to see what happens. So, and I will go over the rows of this table. But before, did you try as a rumor or come directly here?
Yeah,
I'm sorry, I didn't notice. The IT on a short notice decided that they need the room. So, in about 2 minutes, I'll go over the columns, but before I comment once more about this tic-tac-toe stuff. Since I'm doing this course for the first time, I do not have very perfectly developed scale of grading, but I will try to find a way to encourage everyone to cooperate, or maybe I do not need you do it naturally, so you interact friendly to each other. But ways to interact will be like those who take the same value of the spin-spin coupling can interact and exchange data and ideas and make sure that they agree and run the code with the same parameters, and later on in the report the results are compatible and can be merged together and described in the continuous code. Also, those who are focused on the same observable and interact and also make sure that there is a compatibility. And I think we'll go just as partners and as serious researchers, but if needed, if this class needs to be offered to like undergrads with some simplification, maybe one can put like 20% of the grade for evidence of cooperation. So the chatting, not cheating, is encouraged. So please talk to each other about the projects and exchange data as we go through. Okay, so different tools. The middle column is the easiest. So in some sense, the central one is the easiest. If you look for the easy life, probably there will be competition for this point on the board. So you just do what Ichi presented.
Yeah.
Like you show heat capacity.
Yeah.
Well, Ichi did this one. Heat capacity for J is smaller than zero. Those who will be doing, will do heat capacity with J equals zero, and it is expected to reproduce the result from your homework. So, and here it is unknown, but maybe by manipulating with magnetic field, one also can get something. I anticipate that the peak will be much narrower. And we will discuss why and how later on. Okay, so what are the first and last points? The previous part of this class was dealing with concept of density of states, right? So density of states, which is equidistant set of peaks for harmonic oscillator, right? It will be peaks that get denser, and then continuous for hydrogen atom, right? So lowest state if you go energy up, and for the rotator, they are denser at the beginning and then get sparser, right? Does it agree with what you've heard? And okay. And for more exotic and specific systems, there are different profiles, but density of states is something that one can fit into a procedure for computing partition function. Even the code that you have presented doesn't explicitly use concept of density of states, it just uses energies. But if we want to look on all states that contribute to all microstates that contribute to this thing, we may think on the language of density of states to apply our scientific intuition on one hand, and on another to communicate with those scientists who do not understand other languages rather than the language of density of states. So in, again, I do not guarantee, but in some situations it can be beneficial and helpful. And after I stop chatting here, I'll show a couple of slides with a demonstration. So the code that you practiced does save the file with name states. And out of this file, one can immediately develop density of states. If we decide to go to the lab, I'll show how. If not, and if you have enough time, we'll just postpone it to the next time. So I'll erase this one and show in a freestyle what to expect. So we have energy, we have density of states, and for situation of anti-ferromagnetic, J smaller than zero, the lowest state, the ground state, will correspond to all spins oriented in the same direction. Right? And there will be only one state, so there will be only one peak. Then we can flip one spin. So this is a microstate. We can take, for example, first spin, flip it. And then because of the spin-spin coupling, which is negative, if we put minus time minus, it will add energy to overall energy of microstate. So it will be one spin flip. And you were recently taking true statistical thermodynamics, right? So if there are only four spins as shown in this diagram, how many instances, how many degenerate copies of this configuration can be available?
Four,
right? Everyone agrees. So it is degenerate times four. So it will be four times higher, right? Then the so it different spin can be flipped. Then the next one, when we have two spins flipped, how many configurations? Yeah, everyone agrees on six. Okay, so we'll be a little higher. And it will be again offset, so two flips. Right? If you have more than four states, there will be additional set peaks. So if we set up energy equal to thermal energy, temperature equal to zero, then the Boltzmann factor will facilitate only the lowest ground state to be occupied, right? There will be the Boltzmann factor to occupy the first spin flip will be insufficient. And the one to occupy next one will be negligible at all. As temperature increases, there will be more and more population to the first and second flip. And on this language, one can interpret the results. Remember when we were deriving heat capacity for two state spins, it is exactly what we will do. We are just taking Boltzmann factors for spin up and spin down. And here is the same thing, but there are much more states. If we add magnetic field splitting increases, if we put J equals zero and no magnetic field, they all will smash here, right? And right now there is a trend that the degeneracy for ground state is no degeneracy, and then it increases. If you manipulate with this J coupling, it may go in the opposite way. It may be very degenerate and lower, and then go down as we go higher in energy. So basically. What is density of states? Can you tell? Sohi? How would you define density of states? No, just try. Is it like density means like they are dense or sparse, right? Dense or sparse in respect to what? What is
on energy levels based on the energy levels?
The energy levels. Yep, makes sense. Yeah.
A number of cells per unit volume.
Right. Number of states per
cells.
Interval of energy. So if you take not like density or in Archimedes sense, but density of how many states are in this delta E interval, like there is one. And some people do it just as a little bar instead of tick. So DN DE. So it is a formal definition of density of states. And there is a little, I wouldn't say freak, but there is an optimized definition of density of states for practical applications. And I believe and hope you will like it very much. So I will write one short equation. It is not the most complicated one in our careers, but it will be a little counterintuitive. So just prepare to concentrate a little bit, not in the complication, but in thinking out of the box. So I will again write density of states as function of energy, and then summation over all states, delta function, energy minus energy of microstate. Do you see this equation online? Is it sufficient zoom?
Yep.
Okay.
Yes.
So any comments or protests or arguing? When I saw this equation for the first time, I was very against it. And it was like several years after my thesis dissertation. So I was hating the person who introduced this equation, but it should be very natural. So please tell your feedback. How do you interpret this equation?
What is a delta function?
The partial derivative, isn't it?
Please give me a sign who is happy with delta function, unhappy with delta function, or not sure, needs more comments.
Comments would be good.
Okay.
Pretend we're not math people.
No. Delta function is a mathematical abstract concept. It doesn't exist in nature.
Okay.
It's like a spherical horse in a vacuum. If you heard this story. So one of the philanthropists decided to give like grant funds to a person who will predict outcome of the horse race.
Mm.
So, and there were three competitors, the statistical person, either I don't remember, history person or biology person, and mathematician. So statistical, like, so we take distribution last years, previous years, we find maximum root mean deviation with a certain confidence factor, the horse in the pool 5 will come either first or second. Okay. The biologist tells, like, we need to measure length of the tail, divide by the length of the leg, and the one with better parameter will come quicker. Mathematician tells, it's too early to give a definite answer. I need 5 years more to continue calculations and 5 million more of funding. But by today, I am confidently can present you a model of a spherical horse in a vacuum.
Okay.
So delta function is a kind of spherical horse in a vacuum. It's not a practical thing. So I'll erase this one, because you still need this little table. I can give formal definitions, maybe later, so that we do not scare each other. And first I give more practical from engineering point of view. Although I think we have payment from engineering, right? Are you from civil engineering or electrical engineering? If you are payment, are you online? Maybe he's not.
He's from civil engineering.
Oh, okay. So delta function somewhat relates to, if you forget about math, to electrical engineering, to processing of signals, like if we want to soldering of the electronics and do equalizer for sound system. So suppose we do have like signal, whatever, electric current as function of time, and we have a no current, and in certain point of time it appears. So in before transmission of sound by wires, it was like telegraphic style. So if, so it goes from zero to one in some units, if we want to develop the derivative of this practical function that just shows how current goes through the line over time. So when the line is flat, the derivative will be flat, zero. And what will be the value of derivative when we have a spike, when the instantaneously the intensity changes?
It's instantaneous?
Yes.
Would it be one?
If it's changing instantaneously, it would be infinity, right?
Yes, yes. So delta function is a function which is infinitely high, right? And infinitely thin. So this the thickness is zero and height is infinity. Okay. And this is engineering definition of delta function, and this step when it goes from zero to one. Or some people use letter theta. It's a Heaviside function. T bigger, let's set it to zero. Bigger than zero, smaller than zero, bigger or equal to zero. So Heaviside function and delta function. Make sense? You've told yourself infinity, right? It's your words, not mine. So it's theta function and delta function, one can tell that it is infinity if t equals to zero, and zero if t is not equal to zero.
So delta functions define the derivative of step function?
Exactly. And okay. Step function is integral of delta function.
Sure.
So delta is d theta dt. And theta is integral from zero to, or from minus infinity to t, delta t prime d t prime. So if, please show if you saw it before, never saw it before, or somewhat. Oh, I'm so happy. I didn't know that I can be beneficial to introduce these simple things, but well, they're counterintuitive. But now let's go to actual mathematical part. This one was practical, and it is not a main subject of our discussion. It's just a little auxiliary stuff. Now, the thing that is typically used in all areas of science, not only physical chemistry. The main property. If one, let me check if we have different colors. So if you have arbitrary function, f of t, right? And now we do the following. By the way, if you put here infinity, the answer will be 1, right? So we play the following mathematical game. We do integral from minus infinity to infinity function of t times delta function of t dt. What will be the answer? So if we
would it just be the integral of the f of t?
F of zero.
Well, it's f of zero.
F of zero. So f of zero. When our function was without any factor, integral was given 1. If you multiply it by something. At this point, f of 0. If you pick up, if you point the value of this function, or we can do even more advanced. We can t minus t tilde, and then it will pick up the value of the function in the point t tilde, which means we will shift our delta function and define it not at 0, but at some other point. So by multiplying arbitrary function by delta and integrating, one can pick single value. So for practical applications, mathematically it is not needed. But if we need to design an algorithm, if you blindly process some data set, and we don't know much how long it is, how many data points, and if it is not like Excel spreadsheet that we see, if it is some ancient computer that is black box, if we do not see the data, but we can only send an order, I want only one value at certain point of time, then one can program or through circuitry implement this operation and then pick up value of function. Okay. Today's meeting is devoted to the delta function. Thanks to John. That's okay. Now, it's still a spherical horse in a vacuum. But what if we... okay, I'll draw this table again. You already know what it is, right? So please guide my hand if I want to plot this function.
What's under the square root?
Huh?
What's under the square root?
2 pi sigma.
Okay.
Do you know this function? No. The exponential to the minus x squared.
Gaussian distribution.
Exactly. It's so like normal distribution for grades in undergraduate courses with 300 attendees, right? So please, if and now it is centered in zero, we can put here x minus zero squared at x equals minus infinity, it will be zero, right? E to the power minus infinity is zero. At x equals plus infinity, it will be also zero, right? And it is always positive. Now I'm not watching, so guide my hand. Should I, tell me when I should go forward, up or down?
it should slowly be going up.
Okay.
It should, kind of like a water.
I'm not watching, I'm just following your command.
Yeah.
Tell me up, down.
Up.
Keep going up.
What?
Keep going because you're not to the center line yet. Keep going. Keep going. Getting close. Getting closer. And start coming down. Oh, we missed it.
We overshot it a bit.
Okay, but
down and then back down the same way.
Yeah. Keep coming down. Keep coming down. Down, down, down. You're going, like, not down. Oh, now you're going down a lot.
Okay, enough. So, it is a peak, and the peak is well-defined, right?
Uh-huh.
So it goes with some curvature one way, then curvature other way. So what is the parameter sigma here and there? What if you put sigma very, very big? If you put sigma equals like 100, or better, sigma equals infinity. If you put sigma.
Does that relate to the width?
Exactly. If you put sigma infinity, then this curve will become very, very broad, right? Just equals almost equals one. If you put sigma equals close to zero, like 0.0001, it will become sharp, right? So the delta function of x is limit of sigma goes to zero of this Gaussian function. And if we put center point here, if we add this little subtraction, it will be centered not in zero, but in some other place, right? We shift the whole function. So from this definition, we can practice the density under density of states. We will understand Gaussian functions with quite small width. And then we just make the x-axis, put energies that we compute by some other subroutine. And here one can also put degeneracy if there are like degenerate states. And then dress each one with this little profile. So if they are sparse, it will be individual peaks. And if the states come closer to each other, then peaks will be combining together. Okay? So the row number one in our hypothetical table, so three attendees of the class will do density of states for different values of j. And it was much longer to speak than to do practically. By the time we discussed it, it could be done for all three. Okay, first column is density of states for each value of j. Second column, the response of system to temperature, meaning scan temperature as we did before, right? And the third one will be scanning magnetic field. We didn't do it before, but it is very, very quick change. In the variable, we keep the variable scan, and later on, you may remember there was a settings that temperature or temperature times Boltzmann constant equal to scan times something, right? So we were screening different values of the scanning parameter. Now we will set magnetic field equals scan times some parameter, and temperature will be predefined for the whole thing, right? So we will just look how the partition function, and energy will be changing along the, like, it will correspond to a measurement when we turn the knob for the value of magnetic field. So it's a lower row. And most novel, I'm not sure if it is mostly challenging, but most novel will be in this tic-tac-toe cell, will be the one lower right. So it will be magnetic field for positive J, which we didn't explore before. So if you look for a challenge, you can try this one. The least challenging will be for scanning of temperature for J less than one. So this is simplest, and probably this one is second simplest. Okay, let's start filling the table, and then after I'm look at time, and you'll decide what to do, either to complete for today or go to the lab or just chat a little bit. Okay, so did you get the link online? If you are online, you can start. Okay, and if you are in class here, you can just approach and put your name somewhere here. So I'm inviting you to just approach this stage and vote. Yeah, maybe one can type in there. And yeah, maybe remove this one and type directly in the table, yes. Okay. So, one, two, we have five. Who didn't vote yet? Okay. And we have two. So, Chameli did vote. Eamon?
Yes, I'm trying to sign in.
Okay. Maybe not. Well, I will go over and maybe reassign later. And if I notice that someone with big potential selected something simple, I will suggest swapping. Okay, yeah, thank you for filling. And if you are not going to the lab, then I will just meditate on it and communicate final decision, but taking your opinions into account as a primary thing. Yeah, many thanks. Okay, and yeah, I think we can skip going to the lab for today if there are more weeks. So just couple of slides. So basically, it is a summary of what we did before, what we did today, right? So ferromagnetic, paramagnetic, anti-ferromagnetic, and three tasks for each. And this is the image that Crystal was showing, and derivative of it is not energy, it is magnetization. So it is for here is the image that Crystal was showing, and here is the derivative that Ichi was showing, right? And I'm showing the results for the ferromagnetic, or this one is magnetization. So when temperature is small enough, all spins are collinear. And if you have 32 sites and each spin 1/2, then it is minus 16. And until substantial temperature is zero, and then as temperature grows, it will slowly approach zero. And at the point where it changes a lot, it is approximately the same critical point where both response of energy and magnetic field to temperature will have a peak. So here is the density plotted for our favorite case that we already covered last time. Ferromagnetic J smaller than zero. And this line for density, of states is computed as we discussed now in class. So you see peaks, and each peak means it is different number of parallel spins. But if we do literally as we discussed right now through delta functions, even for this very humble small system, 32 is nothing. But number of degeneracies, if you compute, is really huge, and it goes to large numbers. And maybe there is something substantial and important at different energy, but we just do not see it in comparison to other things. So one can do the same thing, but convert it into logarithmic style of plot. And when we will be next Wednesday in lab, it is just one quick modification in MATLAB. So one plot the same line, but the ticks on axis change logarithmically by orders of magnitude. And then one can see that in addition to this peak, which is macro peak, composed big maximum for overall density of states, contributed of a lot of little peaks from each microstate. So in addition to this feature, which looks a little bit more smooth in logarithmic scale, there is the ground state. So it is not seen in the upper, in the linear y-axis, but if we practice log scale, it is well seen. And analyzing ground state can later on help to interpret other results. I was just playing and counting number of peaks. So for if one carefully go over total number of this little little features is think should be 33 or 16 up, 16 down, intermediate cases, and the one equal number for up and down. Okay, the maximum in the overall distribution is not at the equal is shifted because of the magnetic field, so which will also vary. I think it is enough for today. Do you want to hear anything else?
Say no.
Okay, so by the democratic vote, it is suggested that we finish now. Everyone is okay? Okay.